Hello everyone, welcome back to Medmiracle. Today we are going to discuss about the important topics in ENT. So let's see the important topics in ENT. The first topic is the nerve supply of pinna. You have to know the nerve supplies, the various nerve supplies on the median and lateral surface of pinna. Even an image based question can come from this topic. The second topic is the three-dimensional image of middle ear. A question per se won't come from this topic, but having a three-dimensional image of the middle ear in your mind will help you out in the understanding the pathophysiology of various diseases, and even in otoscopic image identification also it will help you. The third topic is developmental anomalies, just like Montini's dysplasia. You just have to know what is that anomaly. That's it. You don't have to go in detail, just know what that anomaly is. The fourth point is hearing loss. So this is an important topic and you have to know in detail. So here you have to know the types, such as whether it's sensory neural or whether it's conductive hearing loss, and how to differentiate it, like the various tests available and what all features will be shown in that, be it the tuning fork test, whatever the positive findings are in the conductive hearing, sensory neural loss, or in cochlear and retrocochlear, what are the difference you can expect. This was what I was talking about. This is the three-dimensional image of the middle ear cavity. This image is adopted from Gray's anatomy. This was the nerve supply of pinna which I was talking about. You have to be thorough with this image. There is no way you can escape it. The next important topic in ear is tuning fork test. You have to know the names of the various tests, name, procedure, what do you mean by positive and negative of the test, and in what types of hearing loss you see it. Okay, then come the next topic, that is the audiogram. So in audiogram you have to know the various charts that is in. First you have to know what the basics, various signs are there, and you have to know what does each sign mean. Next thing you have to know, what are the audiogram images you can see in various conditions, such as mean ears, that is a low frequency hearing loss, so it will be upward slant. In presbyacusis the slant will go down because it's high frequency which is lost. In otosclerosis, 2000 hertz make deep IGA, which is known as Gerhardt node. In noise induced trauma, 4000 peak deep air. So we have to know first the basics of audiogram, second the audiogram images you can see get in various diseases. These two things are important in audiogram. This was what I was discussing about in presbyacusis, slanting down because high frequency is lost. So you have to know the basics and the various images in disease condition. Now another topic that is important is Barra waveforms. In Barra waveforms, you have to know the how each wave is created. Proximal and distal cochlear nerve, or is it the olivary nucleus which causes it, or the inferior colliculus which causes it? The mnemonic is E. coli. So you have to know how each wave is produced. Then coming to some disease topics, what you have to know is otomycosis. In otomycosis, you have to know the organism causing it, and image also you have to know. Spot diagnosis and image based question can come from this question. Then in ASM also, what you have to know is the organism, and you have to know necrotizing ASM, the organism causing it and the clinical feature and organism. You have to know about necrotizing. In CSOM, what you have to know is the types and the management. In management part, it's mainly the surgery types you have to know, whether it's radical mastoidectomy, modified radical mastoidectomy, canal wall up, canal wall down. You have to know the various types of surgeries available. The other part you have to know about CSOM is the complication part, various extracranial, intracranial complications that can arise from CSOM, and like the signs, for example, Pickett and fever. So there are multiple eponyms in this section which we have to know. Then coming to the next topic that is important is the tympanoplasty types, meningoplasty in the types 1, 2, 3, and in which all condition and what all the structures are removed in each, you have to know.
If we look at this slide, on the bottom right, we have an important image of tympanosclerosis, and on the top left, we have an image of serous otitis media. These are two important images in ear that everybody should remember.
And then these are the four diseases you have to study in detail. In detail means you have to know the pathophysiology, you have to know the clinical feature, you have to know the investigation, not just the names. We have to know in detail. If you are doing audiogram, what you will see. If you are doing CT, what you will see, if at all. Like in various, depending on the diseases, the investigation will change, and you have to know the investigation and their findings. And if at all, if any, there is an image, you have to study that image also. So next part is the treatment part. So pathophysiology, clinical feature, investigation, treatment. Now coming to the next topic, like it's mainly rehabilitative procedure wala topics. So in this one, you have the cochlear implant, which is the most important one. You have to know the parts and its function, which is within the bone, in the bone. You have to know the parts. So function, parts, you have to know in detail for cochlear implants. Other rehabilitative procedure, you just read in brief, that's enough. You don't have to spend much time on it. Grommet, see the image in situ. Image based question may come. So this was what I was talking about, the cochlear implant. So there are various parts of it. You have to know the function of it in detail. Coming to the nose topic, what you have to know is the leaf food classification. In this, you have to know the clinical features in each day 1, 2, 3. In each, how the patient will manifest, the clinical feature and the examination finding, you have to know. In CSF rhinorrhea topic, what you have to know is like how you will differentiate CSF, be it beta transferrin or that filter paper. You have to know the differentiation, how you identify it is CSF. And the management part is mainly conservative, so it's nothing much in detail about it. Now coming to the next topic, it's about the various openings of the paranasal sinuses. So you have to know the anatomy of nose, at least these openings and the inferior turbinate, medial turbinate, superior turbinate, meatus. You have to know in detail. Now coming to the next topic about epistasis. So first you have to know the arterial supply of the septum and lateral wall. Next we have to know the plexuses that are available, that is the Littles area you have to know, Woodruff's area you have to know, Kieselblatt's plexus you have to know. Now the next point you have to know is the differentiation between anterior and posterior. Anterior and posterior bleeds, like what are the condition which causes anterior bleeds, what are the condition which causes the posterior bleed, and how to differentiate, and the management part also it is different, so we have to know the difference between these two. So this was what I was telling earlier, leaf foot classification. So you have to know this classification and the clinical features. This is another topic which I was telling, epistasis, the arteries which supply this area and plus the artery areas and the plexus, the names you have to know and where it is located you have to know. This is the what I was talking about, the arterial supply of the lateral wall and the septum. Then the other topics which are important in nose is deviated nasal septum. You have to know the types of it. Another one is rhinophyma. Mostly an image based question or just clinical feature, what is the most common diagnosis type question may come from this topic. So we have to read about this topic. Now another topic which you should know is mucormycosis. Clinical feature, organism, you have to know, and the treatment part also. Now coming to the nasal polyp, what you have to know here is the types, ethmoidae, coanale, you have to know, and the clinical feature and the management. Now, it's better you study it in a tabular form, ethmoid means androcoanal polyp. So we have to know the difference between these two. Coming to the oral cavity, the most important topic in this section is the pre-malignant lesions. Erythroplakia, leukoplakia, submucosal fibrosis are the most important among them, but you have to read everything because the question may come, exclude which of the following is not a pre-malignant lesion. So you have to know in detail, at least in detail of all these three, and other names you have to know. Now since you know that oral cavity cancer is one of the leading cancers in India, you have to read about this thing. Don't have to spend much time, focus in the pre-malignant lesion mainly, and thyroglossal cyst also, yeah, just read about it. This is another section which is very important. You have to know the levels and the dissection types, modified radical neck dissection, McAfee incision. You have to study these things. So the levels of lymph node and the dissection techniques and types. Now an image based question, as I was telling, can come in from this topic. This is leukoplakia, you can see, and you note this fibrosis. So this is submucosal fibrosis. Now coming to pharynx wellness section, one thing you have to note is the sites. Like for nasopharyngeal carcinoma, it's fossa of Rosenmüller, and for nasopharyngeal angiofibroma, juvenile nasopharyngeal angiofibroma, it's a sphenopalatine foramen which is the most common site. So this site is important. Then the next thing that is important is the tonsils. You have to know the blood supply, you have to know the tonsillitis, and you have to know the tonsillectomy indication and the complication of the surgery. A endoscopic image also can be asked from this topic. So you don't have to study in detail, but the normal anatomy you have to know, where what all structures lies. So this is the rose position. As I was telling, tonsillectomy is an important topic, so you have to read about tonsillectomy. Then the other topics which are important in pharynx are the abscesses, the difference between peritonsillar and retropharyngeal abscesses is an important topic. Next thing what you have to read about is juvenile nasopharyngeal angiofibroma and nasopharyngeal carcinoma. You have to know in detail. In detail I mean clinical feature, investigation with findings, with images, and the treatment available. So this is Hallmann-Miller sign seen in nasopharyngeal carcinoma. So as I said, investigation with images, with findings. Now coming to the larynx section. In larynx, what you have to first know is the anatomy, basic anatomy. Just an overview would suffice. You don't have to go in detail. Just like as I said, in middle year you have to know the three-dimensional image. Nothing like that is required. Just basic anatomy of larynx is sufficient. And the other part which is important is the congenital anomalies. Congenital anomaly would be laryngomalacia, laryngeal web. You have to know these things. Now coming to the x-rays, two x-rays which is important here is Kraup and epiglottitis, is the staple sign, the thumb sign, and all you have to know. Now coming to the next topic, it's about vocal cord palsy. You have to know the positions, whether it's medial as well shifted to the lateral side, whether in RLN palsy, in SLN palsy, what are the findings you get. You have to know in vocal cord palsy, you have to study in detail, word by word you should know. Now the next topic that is important is in the differentiation of vocal nodule, Wynn's polyp. Now coming to the other topic which is important is respiratory papillomatosis. This topic was asked even in AIIMS May 2017, so you have to read about it. Clinical in features, investigation, and treatment. The next topic is the laryngeal carcinoma. You don't have to read it in detail, but a basic overview should be there, at least about the staging you have to know. And the treatment, mostly it's surgical, but the rehabilitative procedure also you have to stress on. So this is one of the images that could be asked, respiratory papillomatosis. So these are the things you can see here. So this was what I was talking about, the x-ray in Kraup, staple sign is seen. You can see this is getting tapered over here. So this was the other topic which I was talking about, vocal cord position, situations in healthy condition and in diseased. Now coming to the next topic, that is important is the procedures. And in ENT, the one of the most important procedure is tracheostomy. You have to know the procedure, the tubes, the complication and the duration, like how long you can put one tracheostomy tube, how often you have to clean it. That's all you have to know in detail. Now the next thing that you have to know is the indirect and direct laryngoscope, the hidden areas in indirect laryngoscope, and you have to know how these procedures are performed. Procedures you have to know in detail, because nowadays a lot of clinical questions are coming, so we have to know how it is done, the proper way. So this is what I was talking about, the tubes, the parts of it you have to know in detail. And this is direct laryngoscope procedure, left hand. Now coming to the instruments part, basic vocal instruments. You don't have to study each and every instrument, you just have to identify the treatment, where it will be like, well, which in which instrument is used in so and so surgeries and all. You don't have to go in detail, but by the descriptive part only you will be able to guess it. So spot identification of instrument would be sufficient. So which all instruments you have to stress? Tracheostomy tubes, laryngoscope, rhinoscopy, Bloom-Singer process, speculum, and otoscopic images of various diseases. I have shown you two images already, so stress it on. So mostly they will ask laryngoscope, rhinoscopy, those things they will be asking. So this is positive rhinoscopy mirror. Now coming to the x-ray part, I have already shown you one x-ray of Kraup, staple sign, epiglottitis, thumb sign. These are the views, few specific views which we use in ENT. So you have to know when it is used and what identification. An x-ray may give and ask you, they will be asked like, what is the image shown, which type of view is this. So you have to know it. So this is Waters view for the paranasal sinuses. Thank you.